I'm going to teach you how to do a high detailed drawing of a person because a lot of people are frustrated with that. So when drawing, it's good to create a good environment for you. So I always bring out my dinosaur lamp. I like my dinosaur lamp. I also bring out my dinosaur friends, such as Papilio and little Frederick.
Hello.
I like him. His eyes are really creepy. You want to start off drawing a person like this. You're going to want to start off with a nice, good face for a figure. I always start off with something nice and small, like this. This way I can leave room for any accessories on the face and the head. Next, you're going to want to start off with a neck. Now, I'm making a self-portrait and I don't have a neck. So it's good. If you don't have a neck and you're making a self-portrait, you're gonna want to go like this. Maybe I have intense arms, so I always like to show the definition of my arms in my art. So it all depends on who you are, what you look like. Next, I put the wrists. On one of my arms, I have a photon cannon. So it's very difficult to draw that. You probably don't have one. So I draw my photon cannon with high details. On my other hand, I have a clamp type thing going on, so I can grab stuff really far away. It also doubles as a taser. Next, you're going to want to draw the body. I have intense nipples, so I like to define my abs like they really are. My 8-pack. Next, you really want to draw your legs, which are usually difficult to draw, especially in my case, because one of my legs is super robotic and the other one's really muscular. Actually, one of my legs has a machine gun. It's pretty awesome. And then muscular legs are much more difficult to draw than machine gun legs. So you're gonna want to get the veins in there. My feet are platform shoes. I don't wear platform shoes. My feet are actual platform shoes. It's a birth defect. And they have fish in them. I don't know how I was born with that. I think my parents did that, but I don't know. I was born with a really epic hat. Because my parents gave it to me. So basically, that's my hat. Okay, my eyes. One of my eyes is has heat seeking. That way, if I ever have a rocket launcher, I can just hit people with my heat seeking thing. It's hooked up to a computer processing system in my brain. So there's my computer processing system. My other eye. I hit it with an eye patch. I have no reason for it. It just looks really awesome. You guys agree. Eye patches are just awesome. I also have like this emo hairstyle type thing going on, so do that. A lot of different hairstyles are different to draw. You know what you have. You know what to do for yourself. My lips are sugar. Your lips are usually plastic. Now, whenever I do like self-portraits of myself like this, I like to draw my pets with it. So I sometimes draw my pet dinosaurs. happened, then you finish off the details a little bit. And I usually frame my work. So, that's how you draw a person. Finished result should look something like this. You've got close-up details here. It's not my best work, but you know, it's good for a beginning. So that's how you draw a self-portrait.